This review is coming to you live from inside my car. Well, sort of live. Close enough to live, whatever. In a very shocking update, we have our first theatrical DNF. I did not finish, and I do mean I walked out of the theater at the 1 hour mark, and I think the movie's only like an hour and 45 minutes because my senses couldn't take it anymore. And it's not that it was too scary. I mean, it had a couple of jump scares, but whatever. But number one, it's loud as shit. And there's no way it was the theater I was sitting in, because during the regular talking parts, it was fine. But as soon as the scary thing comes on, it's fucking loud to the point I couldn't sit there anymore. And I know I've complained about that before with, like, The Conjuring and things, where, like, the opening song, note, whatever you want to call it, is super loud. And then the rest of the movie is fine, except, like, a shriek here and there. No, this is repetitive screaming, and I personally couldn't take it. The other thing being is that it does a lot of these repetitive scenes over and over and over. Do y'all remember that subway scene in Madame Web? It does that, but it did it in 1 hour, like, I think 3 times or 4 times, and I was over it. I was over this movie. I don't know what's going on, and I didn't have the patience anymore between that and all the loud fucking noises. And some people might like it. Good for you guys. This just, it's too close to A Cure for Wellness for me. And if you saw my reviews for A Cure for Wellness, number one, thank you for being around that long. Number two, you would know that I had to do like 5 videos to talk about A Cure for Wellness. So this was definitely not for me. If you are sound sensitive, this is not going to be for you. So stay tuned. I think I'm going to try again tomorrow with the Blake Lively one. I didn't read the book, but everybody and their mothers at the theaters tonight for it. So stay tuned for that one. Okay, bye. I don't have a fucking song for this.